When I was 17, I was responsible for taking this high school trip. So I organized it. And we went to a, I met a past alumnus of my high school who was happened to be a chancellor at a med school. So we went up there and I ended up going into this observatory for surgery. And I got in trouble because my friends, my classmates were sort of fallen by the wayside, and we had three adult supervisors, and they were taking the guys out because they were passing out. And so, but I ended up staying for about 5 hours over this dome watching surgery, and I pretty much knew right then and there that that's what I wanted to do. So that and the affirmation, you know, I when I was a med student, again, it happened to me. When I rotated on surgery, and pretty much affirmed that that's probably going to capture my interest for 25 or 30 years, and I've got about 4 or 5 of those left. So, and I'm really happy I did. So those are the two things that really stuck out to me to make me choose to capture my attention for 30 years. It took me a little bit to formulate it, but the gifts that I was given clinically, and they are gifts, they were given to me by my God. And when people come to see me, I extend them these gifts of my clinical knowledge, but to do it in an empathetic manner because they're frightened. It's taken me a little while to learn that, but that's really my philosophy, to try to extend my gifts of my clinical knowledge in an empathetic manner, because these people are scared when they come to surgery. And, you know, to me, it's pretty important to allay their anxiety. And I didn't realize that right at the first, but I'm sort of catching on. Drink water with every meal and walk away from the table a little bit hungry, pretty much.